Next time you find a penny, imagine it represented $100 million. Just what can you do with that kind of money? My mind can't comprehend such big numbers, so I decided I would try to get online and hypothetically spend my $100 million penny. Check it out. Of course, the first thing I'd do is pay off all my debts. My credit cards, my student debt, my car loans, my mortgage. The total consumer debt per American averages out to be $44,000, and here's my penny. Now, I'm completely debt-free, and of course, I want to do the same thing for my spouse. And heck, my parents, my grandparents, four of my uncles and aunts, my three brothers and sisters, their spouses, six of my nieces and nephews, five of my cousins. And of course, I'll do the same thing for my entire wife's family. Then throw in five of my buddies, five of her friends, and 10 other random strangers just to make their day. I'd pay all of their debts and so that they're completely debt-free, and here's my penny. I celebrate with an all-out decked-out luxury trip to Disney World with 10 people for a week, and here's my penny. After this, my wife and I decided to do a little globetrotting, so we set out to see the world, traveling only first class everywhere we go, eating the most fine dining, and staying in the most luxury resorts, seeing everything we had ever dreamt about seeing, living on a shoestring budget of $8,000 per day. We do this for an entire year. And here's my penny. Get back home and decide I need an Ivy League education. But before I graduate, I prepay 10 other people's entire tuition. My kids, my grandkids, and a couple other people I feel are bright. And here's my penny. And since I didn't actually want to work, I decided to invest enough to be able to live off the interest. 15 mil at 8% yields me a cool check of 100 thou a month. I never have to work another day in my life. And here's my penny. I decided to give 10% of my entire wealth to feed starving children in Africa. Through an organization like World Vision, for 35 bucks a month each, I can give food, water, education, and healthcare to some 24,000 kids.
For a year.
If you put them all into cars, that would fill up at least three times the amount of cars you see here. And here's my penny. I decided I need to settle down and buy a little home, so I look at something like this, or maybe something like this with so big it has its own zip code, or this, or something like this with its own private water park on the beach. And here's my penny. Of course, I need a few toys, so I purchase this car, and then grab a Ferrari, and pick up a McLaren F1, and a Lamborghini, and the most expensive car in the world. And here's my penny. And I cannot go without a luxury vacation home in the Bahamas, so I pick up this pad, and here's my penny. And to get there, I need my own private jet. And to get around the island, I need my own private helicopter, just for fun. And here's my penny. At this point, I've spent barely over three quarters of my $100 million penny, and I honestly can't think of anything else to buy. I could get on Facebook and pay off all the debts of 500 of my friends. I could invest and make another 40K a month in interest. Or I could support another 60,000 African children for a year. Or heck, I could even throw a lavish $10,000 party every weekend for the next 50 years. At this point, it should be quite evident that this $100 million penny is worth a lot. Now, using these $100 million pennies, I would like to show you just how much was taken from the taxpayers and given to the mega banks through the TARP bailouts. Check this out. Wait. This $700 billion atrocity committed by Congress made the people rightfully furious and was largely responsible for giving birth to what we now know as the Tea Party. But while the Tea Party was distracted protesting this bailout, check out what was going on behind closed doors in absolute secrecy at the Federal Reserve. that, my friends, was the secret $16 trillion bailout exposed by the first ever government audit of the Federal Reserve, thanks to Congressman Ron Paul. As terrible as Congress's bailout was, it doesn't take a fiscal conservative to recognize that it was but a distraction compared to the real theft of the American people going on behind closed doors at the Federal Reserve. $16 trillion, by the way, is enough to pay off every credit card, student loan, auto loan, and mortgage of every American citizen. The total consumer debt, plus giving every one of them $8,000 of fund money to boot. Instead, it was stolen from the American people and dished out to the politically connected friends of the Federal Reserve. And while the establishment politicians covertly go along with this scheme, there is one we can trust to speak the truth no matter the consequences, to fight in Congress to stop the theft and end the Fed. With Dr. Paul leaving Congress, her name is Karen Kotowski. To learn more, go to KarenWho.com and contribute as your part in the fight to end the Fed. You can't afford not to.